Hi everyone, my name is Betty. I'm a product manager here at Clio. And prior to joining the product team, I was on the data migrations team working directly with customers. So might have helped some of you here with your onboarding or your data migrations. I then since moved on to the product team to help customers with their email management workflow. Specifically, I worked on the Clio Outlook add-in. So if you have any questions on that, please feel free to find me at the product lab later on the presentation. So today we'll be talking about all of the wonderful tools that Clio has developed for Microsoft to help our customers to do their best work. So by leveraging the integration between Clio and Microsoft 365, your firm can save more time and bill more hours. And we'll be highlighting the following features here in this integration, or in the presentation, which are the calendar sync, communication using Outlook, contact sync and documents and OneDrive, as well as Microsoft Teams. So before we dive right in, it should be noted that there are different levels of subscription here that these tools are compatible with. So please make sure that you have one of the following listed here. For the most part, they are compatible with the business level subscriptions, but we have made the add-in recently available to the free personal Microsoft accounts. So I really encourage everyone to give it a shot here, even if you don't have a business level subscription. So Jacob here is a fictional character that we've created to help walk us through a day in his life as an attorney, to help show how he leverages the Microsoft tools to be able to help run his practice and his firm. So a little bit about Jacob. He is a solo lawyer specializing in family law. He has to wear a lot of hats and basically handles everything from customer management to time tracking himself. He does have a paralegal who helps him out with some of the communication as well as documents, but for the most part, he is a one-man show. Hopefully, this is somebody that maybe a few of you might relate to. So starting off with his day, Jacob always likes to check his calendar to see what his schedule is like for the day, or maybe he is adding some missing details to the meetings that he has for the day. And he's able to do that with the Microsoft 365 and Clio calendar sync. So a seamless sync can take place between both calendars on both platforms. So with the Clio and Microsoft 365, we are able to offer a bi-directional sync with the calendars between the two platforms. So anything that you add to one calendar will automatically appear in the other. And the great thing about the sync is that this is something you can set and forget. So you will seldom need to reestablish a sync and your calendars will pretty much be always up to date. And as a best practice, we recommend that the primary subscriber can sync and share the firm's calendar and allow any events and appointments where the firm is the creator to be synchronized. So this allows for shared calendar events to reflect not only across Clio, but also your Outlook calendar as well. In addition, for firms who wish to have separate calendars for different types of engagements, multiple calendars can also be created and synced with Clio. So for instance, if you have a calendar for all your firm's events as well as one for your personal calendar and you would like to sync both, you are able to do that by adding a new calendar in your Clio and sync it to your Outlook. So this can really help you and your firm to stay on top of all of your calendaring needs, no matter the complexity. So moving on, Jacob also likes to save all of his communications that he's had throughout the day with his customers on any matters that he's worked on so they can be referred to at a later date. And the Outlook add-in does pretty much just that. It files entire sets of emails, attachments, as well as time entries that comes through your Outlook email. And so this year we've launched a brand new version of the Outlook add-in. And it's offering a 10 times faster filing speed compared to the legacy add-in and a new time entry template function designed to help lawyers like Jacob and many of you here for a better email management experience. And we know that for many lawyers, filing email is a requirement, but using the right tools can also help you boost your productivity. The Outlook add-in can help, again, file entire threads of email, attachments, and time to help you optimize your workflow. So as a best practice, the Outlook add-in adds time entries for you, but you can also automate this process a little bit. So what you can do is go into your Outlook add-in settings, toggle on the time entry template feature shown here, and you can specify things like who you're filing for, what activity category, UTBMS codes, as well as the duration. And once you specify this information, every time entry you're filling out moving forward, we'll have this automatically filled out for you. So saving you guys from having to do a little bit of manual work. And if you have any corresponding billing rates, that's also automatically filled out as well. And another best practice we recommend is to add the Clio add-in as a quick action on Outlook. So by doing this, the Clio icon will always show up at the top right of every email next to where the reply button is. And you'll be able to access it with just a single click. And to do this, you can go into the settings in your Outlook, either type in quick actions or go through this screen here, go to mail, customize actions, find message surface, and select Clio's Outlook add-in. Once you click save, you're all good to go. That icon will always show up for every single email that you want to file for. So it's about middle of Jacob's day now, and he's on his way to meet a new client. His paralegal enters in some of the contact information into Clio, which then is automatically synced with Jacob's Outlook. Now he has what he needs for his meeting. So the contact syncs helps keep your Clio and Outlook contacts up to date, no matter where the changes are made. So again, we offer a bi-directional contact sync with Microsoft 365. Any contact information you put into Outlook will automatically appear in Clio and vice versa. And keep in mind that if you do choose to stop your sync for whatever reason or delete a contact in your Microsoft 365, all contacts that were previously synced will stay in your Clio account to ensure that no information is lost, especially those with billable time or association with the matter. But otherwise, this is a really great tool to save you and your firm from having to do manual work and duplicate entries in both platforms. And as a best practice, we highly recommend you only configure one sync per account. So we mentioned that having one sync per account is able to help treat one user's contact list as sort of the primary contact list, and having that sync to sync on behalf of the firm allows you to avoid any duplicate contacts or duplicate entries. So moving on, Jacob's client provides him with some new documents, and he wants these documents to be visible in Clio and his Microsoft 360 account. So what he can do is to scan them and add them to his OneDrive, and then they're automatically synced with Clio so that his paralegal can start working on them. So the integration with OneDrive and Clio creates a folder that communicates between both platforms, and these folders can house all of your contacts and their applicable matters. And this tool enables lawyers to work, share, and collaborate remotely. So from Clio, you can access your OneDrive files, add time to them, edit them, and view them on Microsoft OneDrive. So really think of it as a portal or a window where you can access your files anywhere that you have internet connection. And in fact, you can actually access your files even without internet connection. So as a best practice, we recommend that you download any files that you might need when you are working on the go. So how you can do that is that you go into your OneDrive and choose the option to make available offline in Windows, in the Windows File Explorer before you go offline. And this will download everything onto your computer for offline use. And remember to not move or rename the Clio folder from within. So in the next slide, we'll demonstrate sort of how that works. So in your Documents tab, you can go to the OneDrive subtab. Let's say you want to upload any files. So yeah, after you go to the subtab there, you'll see the path that the folder is in. And let's say you want to upload some files, you can click on the green button to do that. And then a pop-up will show up with further instructions, which will open up the sort of file explorer for you to pick any file that you want to upload. So once you picked out your file, you can choose to upload. And you can just press the green button there, and you're able to upload the file. And once that's all done, you'd be able to see the file underneath the path of the folder where it is saved to. So maybe you spent a couple of hours working on that particular file and you would like to add some time. Well, you can do that directly from within this page. So a form will pop up basically with all of the basic information that you will need to fill out for the time entry. So things like the activity category, what matter is it going to, and if you have any sort of custom rates set up, that'll be automatically filled out for you as well. And you can just fill out the amount of time that you have spent on that particular document. So once that's all good to go, let's go to the activities tab to see if that time entry has been filed. And we see that it has. And so let's go back to the documents tab. So maybe now that I filed a time entry, it's all great. I now want to see it in OneDrive. So I can just simply click the OneDrive button. Once that's all there, you can see that it's popped up there in OneDrive. All right. So moving on, Jacob wants to end his workday now. He's worked very hard and he wants to end his workday with a progress meeting with all the stakeholders for a particular matter using Microsoft Teams. So there's two really great features that come with Microsoft Teams. The first is Teams Creator and the second is Matter Dashboard. Let's first talk a little about the Teams Creator. So once you have your Microsoft Teams connected to Clio, you can create a Teams space for each of your matter with a click of a button shown here. So that's where the matter is and you'll be able to create a Teams space from there. So once a Teams space has been created, you can open it up directly from within Manage. So think of Teams space as like a chat room or a group chat you have with your coworkers where you can communicate specifically about one matter. So firm users who have permission to those matters on Clio will be added to the team space. And when the space is no longer needed, they can be archived or hidden to help declutter. So this is a really great tool for those who are embracing remote work or running your practice entirely online, or just for those of you who need the flexibility to be able to work on the go. And the other really great feature for those of you who would like to work in one place without having to jump between multiple applications is the Matter Dashboard. It's really built to give you a quick access to your matters, including basic details, events, notes, communications, things like that. So you'll have all of your basic information handy when you're jumping on meetings, and it's really easy to create those contacts while you're video conferencing. And if you wish to see any more detail for this particular matter, you can simply click on the View Matter in Clio Manage button, and it'll take you straight to Manage. And what's really great about the Teams integration is that the Teams Creator feature and the Matter Dashboard feature are separate. And if you want to use one but not the other, you're more than welcome to pick and choose. So as we've seen with a day in the life of Jacob, the Microsoft integration with Clio has allowed him to save more time, bill more hours in nearly every part of his practice. So we really encourage everyone here who's using a business Microsoft 365 account with a Clio account to enable these tools to help save time and collaborate with ease. So thank you so much for your time today. And again, if you have any questions about any of the features I mentioned, please feel free to find me at the product lab just over on that side there. Thanks, everyone.